me, madam?
Yes, thanks. Is everything right in the apartment?
Yes, madam. Everything.
Remember, I want nothing to overlook. Betty's birthday party must be perfect in every detail.
Yes, madam. I understand.
Tell Marie to bring the flowers.
Yes, madam.
And me?
Yes, madam.
The timing you mentioned is perfect.
Sorry.
Henry, get your feet off the table. Where's the birthday gift? Henry, will you answer me?
Were you talking to me?
Of course I was talking to you. Where's the gift?
What gift?
Betty's birthday gift, of course. What have you done with it?
Oh, it's in the library.
Well, go and get it. You don't seem to understand that the guests will be arriving before long and you're not ready to receive them.
I didn't realize it was so late.
And another thing you don't seem to realize is that you're not to lounge about in this room with your newspaper.
Aren't you getting a bit fussy, Martha? You didn't used to care where I read my newspaper.
That was before we moved to the city and into this new house.
Sometimes I wish we never moved.
What's that?
Oh, nothing. Who's coming tonight?
Oh, just a few decades ago, just a friend. Ruth Adams, Helen Maxwell, Archie Pomeroy.
What in the world did Betty invite a half-wit like Archie Pomeroy?
Betty didn't invite him, I did. And I'll have you understand he's not a half-wit, as you call him.
Well, perhaps I did exaggerate his intelligence.
Henry! You! No, not there, Marie. I want them on the piano. Yes, Mom? No, Marie. On second thought, I think you better place them on the table. Yes, Mom?
What's wrong with your mother, Betty? She just passed me like a whirlwind.
Oh, I just told her Elmer was coming to my party, and she nearly got it fixed.
Elmer coming here tonight?
Why, yeah, didn't I tell you?
No.
I received a letter from him several days ago. I'll get it for you.
Say, that's fine. It'll be a treat to see something fresh from the country. I've been moved up here. Let me see what it says.
Sure.
Thanks for the invitation. I'll be down Friday to see you in your new home. How does it feel to be rich? Swell, I'll bet. I'll be there at 8 o'clock. Excuse my writing. Ma's pressing my new jacket, and she jiggles the table. I have got a surprise for you. Tell your old man to be home. I know a new joke. Adios, Elmer J. Hicks. Quite a letter, Betty.
You'll have to take Elmer and
rub off some of those rough edges, though.
That's just what I'm going to do, Jack. Maybe then I will like him.
It's hard to grasp in your mother's likes and dislikes. She's changed since we moved to the city.
You mean she came into our living?
I wouldn't say that.
But it's true, Dad. Mother's thoughts are centered entirely on money and society. She measures everyone in dollars and cents. That's why she likes Archie Fawnthorne.
And I take it from your manner, you don't.
No, I don't like him, Dad. I can't stand him. You don't like him yourself, now, do you?
Well, I'll admit he doesn't appeal to me. She can't blame the boy so much. It's the way he's been raised, you know. Parents have pampered him. Giving him too much. He's never done anything he always ever will.
I wish Mother could see him Dad.
Your mother's just startled at having more than she's used, more money than she's used. She'll come out of it, though. Sometimes I wish we were back where we started. At least we were comfortable and a lot happier.
I suppose you're right. But the immediate question before the house is what to do about Archie.
Why don't you leave him to your old dad? Betty, you know. And stop worrying your pretty little head.
But I can't help worrying. What should I do?
Just keep on liking Elmer. I'll do the rest. A sense of humor will help one over seemingly insurmountable obstacles.
Meaning exactly what?
Betty, I have a plan that will take care of our young gentleman in question. Very nicely. Your old man is a few more brave than many people give him credit for.
Of course you do. Then tell me your plan.
And have you broadcast anything about the house? I should say not. I'm keeping this one to myself.
The guests are arriving.
I better run.
Oh, no, you don't, mister. You're staying here at the party.
Beg pardon, sir, but there's a peculiar looking fellow at the door who insists he knows you. He won't leave, sir.
Who is he?
I don't know, sir, but he was very rude, sir.
What did he say?
When I asked him to leave, he told me to go lay an egg.
That must be Elmer. I thought so. I'll let him in.
You don't have to. I'll interrupt by myself.
Why, Elmer Davis. How are you doing, my boy?
Fine, how are you? How are you doing?
I'm so glad you came, Elmer.
Thanks. You can go.
Yeah, go ahead, Abe. Brought you something, Eddie.
Oh, thank you, Elmer.
Independent.
Oh, Dad. Henry. A mother, Elmer's here.
So I see.
Hi, Mary.
How do you do? Happy to make your acquaintance.
That's right. Those are all proper phrases with which to acknowledge an introduction.
God, that's what it is.
Of course it is. Then after you've been introduced, it won't do to stand and say nothing. Just make some remark in general about perhaps the weather.
Some remark in general?
Yes, you see, Betty.
I'd like to see you.
Yes, Mother. Excuse me, please, I'll be right back. Don't forget now, some remark in general.
Pleased to meet you. How do you do? Happy to make your acquaintance. Some remark in general. Pleased to meet you. How do you do? Happy to make your acquaintance. Watermelon
dessert. Mr. Levy, come back into the kitchen, please. You mustn't be found here.
Don't get excited. Don't get excited. I want a cigar. If Levy wants a cigar, then nobody's going to stop him from getting it.
Don't you understand? If you're down here,
all is
my job.
My baby, with Phoebe around, you ain't got nothing to worry about. Suppose you did lose your job, do you know what you and me would do?
What would we do,
Mr. Phoebe? I'll tell you what we'd do. We'd go right out.
Yes?
And get you another job.
Come out of there, I'll shoot. Come out. Who are you? What were you doing behind that chair?
Well, I'm over here because I was just picking up stuff.
Put your gun away. He's a friend of the family.
I thought you might be the burglar that's been working this neighborhood. Can't be too careful, you know. Sorry I pulled my gun on you, Mr. Hick.
Oh, that's all right.
Phoebe's the name. Detective Phoebe.
Pleased to meet you. How do you do? Happy to make your acquaintance. Well, some remark in general.
What's that?
Pleased to meet you.
Never mind. Have a cigar.
Thanks.
Have a couple of them.
All right.
You know, Hip, this has got a right nice home here.
And
a pizza.
Yep.
Where are you from?
Eagle Corners.
Eagle Corners? Never heard of it. Far from here?
Well, I've been on the train all day.
Say, I'll bet you're hungry after a long trip like that. Come on out to the kitchen. I'll refix you a bite to eat.
Quick, Mr. Beebe, somebody's coming.
Hold your horses, hold your horses. What you got there?
Watermelon preserves.
Watermelon preserves? Bring them along. Boy, oh boy, do I like watermelon preserves.
Here I am, the life of the party. How are you, pop old boy? Don't bother, smoke a good one. My special brand. Say, where's Betty?
She'll be in shortly.
Fine, great girl, Betty. Does she go for little Archie?
Oh, she likes you, does she?
Does she? You said it. Why, it's strange, but all girls seem to like me.
Yeah, that's strange, all right.
What?
I said, is that right?
Sure is. Wait till Betty sees this.
It's a diamond ring.
Yep, a solitaire, if you like it.
Aren't you taking a lot for granted? Betty has been sentenced to marriage, I'm sure.
I know, but she will when I ask her. That's just what I'm going to do tonight. Some birthday present, eh, Pop?
Have you spoken to Betty's mother about this?
Man, she's all for me. You might have been over here tonight.
Well, maybe you're right. But I'm not so sure from what I heard a few minutes ago.
said she wasn't quite sure about you.
What can I do? How can I get her to like me?
Well, if you really want to get to her good graces, I can give you a tip that will help you out.
Well, what is it?
Sour milk biscuits.
What?
Now, this may sound strange to you, but I'm sure it'll bring results. Just mention sour milk biscuits whenever you get the opportunity.
Sour milk biscuits?
Yes, you see, Mrs. Bixby is crazy about sour milk biscuits. And it seems that weakness for other people who like them.
How extraordinary.
It is, isn't it?
Yep, but I'll try it. Thanks a lot, Pop. Say, I wonder what's keeping Betty.
She's in the library with her mother.
Well, see you later, Pop.
I hope not.
Pleased to meet you. How do you do? Happy to make your acquaintance. Margot. Pleased to meet you. How do you do? Happy to make your acquaintance. I'm Martin.
Well, well, this is Elmer from Meetcha Corner. How are the hops getting along while you're away?
Fine, how about your books?
Meetcha Corner. How anyone substantially isolated from all the finer things of life and stuff like that is beyond me.
And there's a lot of things beyond me too.
Don't forget our chief. We used to be contented too.
Oh yeah, but that's all over now. But to my mind, there's one redeeming feature about the country that should be mentioned.
What's that?
Sour milk biscuits.
Grab it! Give me a hand! Where should we put it? One, two, three. Ouch. Oh, my leg.
running.
No, sir.
But I did feel suspicious carrying your shot in that direction.
No, you can't read what I do. I think it was a suicide. Well, I'll soon find out. First, I think you should give the victim a little praise for his acting. He's a perfect horse. I never knew him to be so quiet. By the rules of the game, I'm permitted to ask the victim one question, so that I may, if possible, find a clue. Dad, can you get up now? Dad? Mother? What is it?
Everyone, get in the next room. You've got to be searched.
Searched? I never heard of such a thing.
Bixby, you lead the way. Sit in on high knees. I'll follow. Put that down. Give it to me.
I won't.
We don't have to get sore.
I won't give it to you.
Well, guess I'll just have to take it.
Get away from me. Leave me alone. Over to Mr. Beatty.
Hello, baby. I was just...
Yes, I see. You mean Father, please. You deceiver.
Now, who's done?
must find it easy to get the message back.
Right this way. I want to talk to you.
Helen, what happened?
That beefy person frightened her.
Oh, is that so? Well, maybe the young lady wouldn't mind explaining why she got up while we were out of room and wiped the candle stick off.
Why? How did you know?
I thought you were baking that thing, so I gave you a little rope. I went out, but I stayed while you watched me.
Why did you do that?
So they wouldn't find...
Find what?
Yes, who?
Archie.
Is he the guilty one?
I don't know, but...
But what?
Well, just before the light came on, he rushed toward us to fix the light, and it's about Mindy. And then he climbed up on the panel.
That's our man. I'll get him.
Oh, wait, Mr. Chief. You must be careful with him. He has fit.
Fit?
Yes, he goes completely crazy.
A crazy man?
Yes. Be careful if you mention Sarah Biscuit. It's a bad sign.
Is he dangerous?
It took three of us to hold him down last time.
Maybe you'd better go. I'll stay and ask a couple of few questions.
All right.
Where were you when the necklace was stolen?
I was sitting on the downpour.
Were you alone?
No. Ruth Adams was with me.
Was she with you all the time?
Yes.
Then the two of you were sitting on the downpour from the time the lights went out until they came on again?
Yes.
I see. Hey, bring in the two girls.
What are you going to do?
Check on this fellow's story.
What's wrong? Don't you believe me?
Of course I believe you. I just thought you might have made a mistake.
He's perfectly insulting. You wanted to see it?
Yes. When the lights went out, you and his fellow were together, wasn't he?
Yes, we were together all the time.
Tell me exactly what you did.
We were standing by the radio. The lights went out, we walked to the stairs.
What happened then?
I can't tell you.
Aha, that sounds suspicious, so you won't talk.
Come on, we can tell it. Surely that would be too high. No, I haven't, but I don't think Howard would let me tell.
So it's Howard. Now we're getting more progressive, Dad. I suspicioned you from the start. It'll go a lot easier with you if you suspect everything right now.
I'm sure that no one is talking about it. I have nothing to
do with this. Go on, Mr. Phillips.
Do you mind?
Of course not.
While we were standing there, Howard...
Yes?
He...
Go on, he what?
He kicked me.
Oh, Lord, is that all?
Isn't that enough? How rude! Why, Howard, you big Romeo. I didn't know you had it.
Sorry to disappoint you all, but I did not kiss Ruth.
Howard, how can you say such things?
It's true. As much as I would have enjoyed it, it never crossed my mind to try such a thing.
Then who was it?
I don't know, but I think a moment ago you mentioned Elmer Hicks was standing next to
you. I might have known. Elmer Hicks, this is the second time you deceived me, and am I all cold? I never want to see you again.
Here he is.
So you're the crazy guy, huh?
What? Nothing, nothing at all. The detective wants to question you.
Well, go ahead with your question, TV. I know all the answers.
Phoebe's the name. Are you a very close friend of 60?
You said it. Just like that. Why, I'm about to engage to Betty.
Is that right, then?
Yes.
Why, Betty? What about Elmer?
Oh, he's out of my life forever.
See? Well, the Vixie and I have three comments too, haven't we?
Whatever are you talking about?
You know, sour milk biscuit. Calm down, Joyce.
be all right?
Yes, come on in. There's nothing to be afraid of.
Me afraid? Phoebe ain't afraid of nothing. I just thought I heard something out in the hall.
What's the matter with you people anyway? I'm getting sick and tired of being pushed around. All I said was sour milk biscuit.
Anything else happened?
Yes.
solely responsible for all this. It sounds very much like his work. When was this young man pulled to the door?
Just before you came in.
Well, I have my men stationed outside, so he couldn't have got by them, which means he must still be in this house to get in more of his dirty work.
Well, I'm home. I won't stay in this house another minute.
I'm sorry, ma'am, but no one is to leave this house until this thing is cleared up, if it takes all night.
Here's the booklet. I found him in the cellar.
What were you doing in the cellar, baby?
Just carrying out your instructions, sir.
My instructions?
You sent word by Marie, sir, that I was to fasten all doors and windows.
And I'm saying, now you're finding time to be locked up.
Yes, you're a bit late.
We locked the window in instead of out. Is everybody here now?
Yes, this is everyone.
Good. Then it's a good time to find out about this evidence this young fellow is about to give. Let's hear it.
Tell us, Elmer. Maybe valuable.
Well, I...
Please don't, Mr. Hicks.
Go on.
Well, I was in the room alone.
Shut up! What'd she do?
Well, she whacked off again.
Why, for free!
Now we're getting someplace. What'd you do that for?
I won't tell!
You're hiding something, and you better tell the truth.
No, you're hurting me!
Leave her alone, Grimes.
You keep out of this.
Take your hands off her.
Please?
I see you don't know much about handling women. Now listen, lady. You know he's all for you, and he wouldn't give you a bump here. Why not just tell us you were trying to shield, and everything will probably come out all fine and then.
Yes, Marie, Mr. B is right.
B is always right. Come on now, tell me why you are pretending.
Well, things that I can tell the truth, I'll leave you. Then I thought he might hit Mr. Bixby and I wanted to help.
So that's the kind of man you are. Stand behind your girl's apron strings for protection. Out of good mind and knock your block off.
I've heard just about enough of you. You keep still.
All right, I won't say any more.
Well, see that you don't.
I won't, but I've got my thoughts.
Well, then keep them to yourself.
I will. They aren't fit to be spoken to.
Well, change the subject.
All right, let's talk about something respectful.
What do you know about this affair?
Nothing.
Nothing, huh? Well, I've got my ideas about you. I think I'll be able to clear this case up in a very short time. Get everybody out of this room.
Everyone in the library, please.
First that mini person pushes us around, and now this fellow starts to go over here.
I don't know. All we can do is we should protect the soldiers.
Henry, I want you to get this affair straightened out immediately. It's a shame to keep these people here any longer.
Yes, my dear. What are you going to do now?
Well, Mr. Bixby, I've come to a conclusion in this case that may startle you considerably.
What, with the stolen necklace? Brass candlesticks and abductions? Nothing would surprise me.
Well, I'm pretty sure that the thief that I'm after is responsible for all of this. And what's more, I'm pretty sure he's one of the persons in that room in there.
Sure, you're joking.
I'm not. Headquarters has no description of this fellow. He could be a member of High Society, or even the butler.
What do you propose doing?
Well, it's my opinion that since everybody was searched immediately after the robbery, the thief must have hidden the necklace in this room to escape detection. Now my plan is, listen.
What is it?
Don't say anything. I'm pretty sure somebody's listening behind the library door.
Should we try and have him?
No. We'll pretend to leave and turn the lights out. Maybe our people will be able to connect. I think it's a good time to go search the service quarters now, Mr. Bailey.
That's a good idea. I'll turn off the lights, make sure no one molests them.